السلام عليكم. اليوم بهذا الفيديو راح أتكلم عن موضوع Interceptive Orthodontics. As we remember in previous lecture, I talked about Preventive Orthodontics. The difference between them, Preventive and Interceptive. Preventive meaning the occlusion is normal, dentition is normal, there is no problem. Only eliminate the factor or treat the problem. No, there is no problem, only to reduce the factor that may lead to the malocclusion in the future. So in the preventive, everything is normal. But in interceptive orthodontic, meaning there is a sign and symptom of the malocclusion. The sign and symptom of the malocclusion have been appeared. There is minor problem. To prevent major problem in the future, also to prevent aggressive treatment in the future. This is the aim of interceptive. Interceptive meaning there is a problem. While preventive orthodontic, there is no problem. Everything is normal. Some procedure undertaken in preventive can also undertaken in interceptive, but the time is different. This is very, very important point to differentiate between them. So in this lecture, I will talk about what's the meaning of interceptive orthodontic? Why does my child need interceptive orthodontic? And finally, the procedure undertaken in preventive interceptive orthodontic. American Association of Orthodontic defined interceptive orthodontic is not the face of the science and art of orthodontic employed to recognize and eliminate the potential irregularity in the developing of dentofacial complex. So there is minor irregularity to prevent aggressive treatment in the future. This is the aim of interceptive orthodontic. Interceptive orthodontic simply meaning diagnosis and treatment of the malocclusion as early as detected to prevent aggressive treatment in the future. The advantage of early intervention are numerous. This has positive effect on the occlusion, developing of normal occlusion, developing of dentition, and also developing of facial structure. This is the importance of early intervention. As with the most thing with the child, timing is everything. That's why a number of American Association of Orthodontic recommend that all kids at age 7 years, all these kids must have their first orthodontic diagnosis or orthodontic screening to see if there is any problem or to eliminate the factor that may lead to the problem in the future. Many of the child at this age will not need treatment, but those patients with minor problem, the early intervention with this child or this kids did have the positive effect on the development of the normal occlusion. An orthodontic exam at this age involves X-ray or OBG panorama to detect if there is any problem, detect the final development of the dentition, occlusion. This is the painless procedure for the child to detect if there is any problem, to treat this problem as early as possible. Orthodontic is not only just for improving the smile of the child, but also improve how the way he can smile, also he can the way to brush his teeth or her teeth. This is very important because the malocclusion may lead to the development of periodontal disease. Also may lead to the development of occlusion, because difficult in flossing, difficult in brushing the teeth, also may affect the speech. So, treat as early as possible to prevent this problem. Also to prevent psychological trauma to the child. In the past, orthodontic treatment start at the age 12 to 14 years. This age when the permanent teeth, all permanent teeth erupted or nearly all erupted. In this age, the dentist can extract the permanent teeth, certain permanent teeth to allow the eruption of the other in the correct position to treat the crowding. But in modern orthodontic treatment, in interceptive orthodontic treatment, at the age 7 to 11 years, as early as possible, treat if there is any problem. This allowed the child to improve the mal occlusion, treat the mal occlusion, and also treat the mal occlusion early as possible, and also reduce the teeth to be extracted in the future at the age 7 to 11 instead of the age 12 to 14. This reduced the teeth to be extracted. And also, this interceptive orthodontic may not need treatment in the future, as at the end result of the interceptive may not need future orthodontic treatment. So this is the advantage and this is the aim of interceptive orthodontic, of early intervention of the problem. This is the difference between interceptive and preventive. When preventive orthodontic, there is no problem, only reduce the factor, eliminate the factor as possible to prevent future treatment, to prevent future malocclusion. But in interceptive orthodontic, there is minor problem. There is a problem. There is sign and symptom of malocclusion to reduce the time as possible at the future. Why does my child need interceptive? Parents should be aware that interceptive is usually early phase of full orthodontic treatment. Also, interceptive care can make further orthodontic treatment less in the future. In some cases, may avoid any further orthodontic care. دائما احنا نحذر الاهل دائما بدونا كاطباء اسنان لما يكون اكو مشكله بسيطه عند الاطفال تكون minor mal occlusion دائما نحذرهم انه ممكن يكون interceptive orthodontic ممكن هو يكون بداية العلاج التقويم اللي يحتاجه الطفل بالمستقبل يكون هو العلاج ممكن يكون طويل يستمر عدة سنوات ممكن هو هيكون جزء البداية الأولى لهذا العلاج وممكن أيضا بالعلاج الأول علاج التقويم بعمر صغير ممكن يكون هذا نمنع عن العلاج بالمستقبل ممكن يكون بس هذا العلاج أو ممكن يكون هو جزء من العلاج اللي حياخذه الطفل بالمستقبل علاج التقويم وأيضا ممكن هذا العلاج يكون هذا العلاج التقويمي بسن مبكر ممكن نتلافى أو نقلل من الوقت التقويم اللي يحتاجه الطفل بالمستقبل هاي دائما النصائح نقولها للأهل عامد يكون واعين بهاي المشاكل للصل عند الأطفال So the procedure undertaken, interceptive orthodontic, serial extraction, correction of developing crossbite, space regaining, control of abnormal habit, muscle exercise, interception of skeletal malrelation, and finally, removal of the soft tissue or bony barrier to enable the eruption of the teeth. This is the procedure undertaken in interceptive orthodontic. Some of the procedure can undertaken in preventive, but the time is different. In this video or in this part, I will talk about serial extraction and her correction of developing crossbite. Serial extraction. Serial extraction is interception or interceptive procedure. Interceptive orthodontic procedure. This one there is minor irregularity, minor crowding in the child in the mixed dentition to prevent the crowding in the future to allow the correct position of the teeth in the correct allow the correct position of the permanent teeth. This by planned extraction of certain deciduous teeth and also permanent teeth in orderly sequence. This is the aim of the serial extraction in orderly sequence to prevent the crowding in the future to treat the minor mal occlusion or minor crowding to allow the permanent teeth or guide the permanent teeth in correct position as possible to guide them in favorable position. Serial extraction is based into two principles. First principle, arch length tooth material. As seen in this picture, arch length tooth material meaning there is no enough space of the permanent teeth to erupt in the correct position. So by selective extraction of certain teeth in the serial extraction, allow the permanent teeth, guide them in the correct position to erupt in correct position as possible. The second principle is physiological tooth material. Physiological tooth material, as seen in this picture, human dentition. As we know, human dentition have ability to move toward the space, have tendency to move toward the space, mesial movement. So by certain extraction, or by extraction of the certain teeth in the serial extraction, teeth can be moved toward the space, guide them in the correct position as possible to prevent ectopic eruption and crowding. This is the aim of the serial extraction, this interceptive procedure. Indication of serial extraction. Serial extraction is indicated in the patient with class 1 malocclusion with minor crowding, minor to moderate crowding from 5 to 7 mm crowding in anterior teeth, not less than 5 mm, 5 to 7 mm. Patient with class 1 malocclusion and also there is a harmony between the skeletal and muscular system. Also, the indication of the serial extraction in arch length deficiency, meaning there is arch length deficiency. As you remember in the previous slide, the principle of serial extraction is the arch length deficiency, meaning if there is excess tooth material and there is arch length deficiency, not enough space for eruption in the correct position. Some of the features present to this indicate arch length deficiency, meaning if there is in the deciduous dentition, there is no physiological space. This indication of arch length deficiency in the future, crowding in the future. Also, if there is localized aggressive recession in lower anterior teeth, this may lead to the meaning there is arch length deficiency, indicate arch length deficiency in the future. Also, impacted lateral incisor or ectopic eruption of lateral incisor, mesial migration of the buccal teeth, abnormal eruption pattern, abnormal sequence of the eruption, lower anterior flaring, ankylosis of one or more teeth. This all indicated of arch length deficiency. Other indication of serial extraction, growth not enough to overcome the discrepancy. If the growth is not enough, discrepancy between the tooth material and arch length, this also indication of the serial extraction. Also, other indication of serial extraction, citrate profile. Child must be citrate profile and pleasing appearance with the harmony with skeletal and muscular system. This is the indication of serial extraction. The contraindication of serial extraction, patient with class 2 and class 3 malocclusion, only with class 1. And also the contraindication, patient with class 1 with minimal space deficiency. This also contraindicated for serial extraction, when there is minimal space deficiency with class 1. So not need treatment. For example, 2 to 3 mm, 2 to 3, 4 mm, malocclusion or crowding, minimal space. So there's no need for serial extraction. Also, patient with hypodontia, missing of one teeth or more. Also with oligodontia, missing 4 to 6 teeth. Endodontia, missing of the teeth. This also all contraindicated for seal extraction. Also teeth with ectopic position. And dissected teeth. Dissected teeth also, this is contraindication for seal extraction. And if there is any mild disproportion between the arch length and tooth material, that can be treated by potential stripping. This also contraindication for serial extraction. Before I talk about the procedure of serial extraction, I talked about the advantage of serial extraction. Advantage of the serial extraction, treatment is more physiologic, meaning use the physiological space, guiding the teeth in the correct position as possible. And also reduce the psychological trauma for the child. Because the early treatment, this improved the way of his life. Improved the way of brushing the teeth, using the floss, prevent psychological trauma, improve the appearance of the child, improve the oral hygiene of the child. This also the advantage of the serial extraction. Also, the health of the teeth, the health of the tissue. We can preserve the health of the tissue, also more stable result. Also, the one of the advantage of the serial extraction, reduce the time in the future, need less retention time. This is the most important advantage of the serial extraction. The disadvantage of serial extraction, need cooperative child because of cooperative child or cooperative patient because of the multiple visit, and also treatment may prolonged 2 to 3 years. An extraction space create during serial extraction close gradually. This may lead to the habit such as tongue thrust because of the space, because the space close gradually. Also, extraction of the buccal teeth can result in deepening of the bite. If the procedure is not carried out properly, there is a risk of reduce of the length, arch length deficiency, if not treated appropriately. Also, serial extraction, there is no single approach to all child. There is different approach. This depends on the time the child come to the clinic, and also the sequence of the eruption. Also, the disadvantage of serial extraction, the axial inclination of the teeth at the end of the treatment. This may need fixed appliance in the future. So, this is the disadvantage and the advantage of serial extraction. Serial extraction procedure. Before we use any procedure, we classify the procedure into three methods. The child, when come to the serial extraction, must select the child or the patient appropriately. The crowding not less than 5 mm, 5 to 7 mm. This involves clinical examination of the patient, also study model, also panorama and cephalometric analysis of the teeth, and the child with class 1 malocclusion, where the harmony skeletal and has soft tissue, muscle and skeletal system with harmony. This is the diagnostic procedure before the treatment planning. The procedure we can classify into three methods. Dual method, tweed method, and finally Nance method. As seen in this picture, this is a tweed dual method. Dual method is most commonly used. This is CD4, meaning at the age 8 to 9 years in the upper teeth, if there is minor crowding to moderate 5 to 7 millimeter to prevent ectopic eruption of the canine, and prevent the crowding of the incisor. In the age 8 to 9 years, we extract C, We extract C, meaning primary canine, to allow the proper eruption of the permanent incisor. This is the aim of the extraction of the C. After 1 year, after the extraction of the C, we extract D, primary first molar. Primary first molar, we extract D. This to facilitate or to accelerate the eruption of the premolar. So, as seen in this picture, to facilitate the eruption. After the eruption of premolar, we extract the premolar. The aim of extraction of the premolar, meaning L4, to allow the canine to erupt in the correct position, not ectopic position, to prevent displacement of the canine as possible. So, this is the aim of this method, dual method, the most commonly used method, in the upper teeth, most commonly. Other method, tweet method. This procedure, different procedure, because this depends on the child, the age of the child, and the sequence of the eruption of the teeth, primary and permanent teeth, because there is no single approach of the same extraction to all child or to all patient. We must put in mind before start the treatment, there is no single approach to all child. The other method, tweet method. Tweet method, as seen in this picture, tweet method also most commonly used in the upper teeth, is the same as dual method, but DC4, meaning extraction of primary first molar first, and then extraction of the C, primary canine. Primary canine to allow proper positioning of the incisor and extraction of the D to facilitate or to accelerate the eruption of the 4. And after the eruption of the 4, we remove it. After 1 year, we remove it. After 1 year from extraction of C and D, we remove the premolar. After the eruption, as soon as eruption, we remove the premolar to allow the canine to erupt in the correct position. The third method is Nance method. Nance method most commonly used in the lower teeth, because in the lower teeth we have a problem. Canine erupt before the premolar. So to prevent displacement of the canine in the abnormal position, buccally or lingually, in Nance method, D4C. D4C meaning C, we retain the C, not extract the C. We extract D first at the age 8 to 9 years. This extraction of the D accelerates the eruption of the premolar. But in lower teeth, to prevent crowding, or to prevent crowding of the canine, to prevent loss of the C, we use inoculation of the premolar, meaning removing of the premolar surgically, meaning removing the tissue and bone to remove the premolar. This to provide the space of the canine to erupt in the correct position. So, Nance method most commonly used in the lower teeth, in the lower crowding, anterior teeth, because canine erupt before premolar, to prevent the displacement of the canine in abnormal position. This is the most commonly method used in serial extraction, or most commonly procedure. The second procedure in interceptive orthodontic is correction of developing crossbite. As seen in this picture, crossbite meaning there is reverse overjet between the buccal, between the upper and lower teeth. There is small relationship, buccolingually. There is lingual relationship of the upper to the lower teeth. Reverse overjet. This is very important, correction of anterior crossbite as early as detected. Because as seen this crossbite must be treated, because anterior crossbite is self-perpetuating. or crossbite in general in the child is self-protruding, meaning if there is crossbite in deciduous teeth, meaning there is crossbite in permanent teeth, and also in the mixed dentition. And also, crossbite, especially anterior crossbite, if a present minor problem in early dentition on the mixed dentition can lead to the major skeletal problem in the future. May need to the aggressive treatment in the future. May need combined treatment, orthodontic treatment, and surgical treatment. So, crossbite, as ill as detected, must be treated. This very, very important point in treating crossbite. Crossbite can be divided into dento-alveolar anterior crossbite, as seen in this picture, meaning one or two teeth in lingual relation to lower teeth, as seen in this picture. This is dento-alveolar, not than two teeth, one or two teeth in lingual relation to the lower. This most commonly due to the over-retained of deciduous teeth. When there's over-retention of the deciduous teeth, permanent teeth may erupt in the lingual position to the lower. This is the most common cause. The treatment of this anterior crossbite, dento-alveolar crossbite, as seen in this picture, first, tongue blade therapy. Tongue blade therapy, meaning as seen in this picture, tongue blade, we put the tongue blade rest in the lower anterior teeth, opposing the teeth in the crossbite, and ask the child to bite with constant pressure for 1 to 2 hours per day for 1 week to 2 weeks. This helps to erupt the teeth in more labial position to treat this single tooth crossbite. Other treatment, cataline appliance. Cataline appliance meaning removable appliance with inclined bite plane in the lower anterior teeth. When the child bites on this bite plane, inclined bite plane, this transmits the muscle force to the teeth to erupt the teeth in the more labial position to treat this lingual relationship or this reverse overjet. Also, other treatment of dento-alveolar crossbite is by using Z-spring, removable appliance with Z-spring. As we know, Z-spring used to treat the bucolingual mal relationship. So, removable appliance with Z-spring or cantilever spring, this is the same name, cantilever or Z-spring on the anterior teeth, on the teeth on the crossbite, to treat the crossbite, and also put the bite plane, posterior bite plane. This is the removable appliance you can treat the dento-alveolar crossbite. Posterior bite plane to open the bite, and Z-spring to correct the bucolingual relationship. Also, other treatment, if there is older permanent teeth. Older permanent teeth, yeah, meaning more permanent teeth in the lingual position than more permanent teeth in the lingual position. All the teeth are permanent. Also, with the other problem, rotation or crowding, we can use fixed appliance. Fixed appliance by putting, as seen in this picture, band on the sixth, and also we can use fixed therapy, wire and band bonded to anterior or four anterior teeth. This is also a fixed appliance in older permanent teeth. When all permanent teeth are present in the crossbite with other problem, we can use fixed appliance. This is all treatment to prevent aggressive treatment in the future. Functional anterior crossbite. Crossbite can be divided dento-alveolar and functional, and finally skeletal anterior crossbite. Functional crossbite, as seen in this picture, pseudo class 3. As we remember, In a previous lecture in preventive orthodontic, I talked about premature contact. If there is premature contact in deciduous teeth without any problem, the treatment with articulating paper is grinding this premature occlusion to prevent any problem in the future when there is no sign and symptom of the malocclusion. This is if we detect there is premature contact in the deciduous dentition. If we not treat this premature contact, this may lead to the pseudoclass 3. Pseudoclass 3 meaning when the child close on the patient close, there is a forward movement of the mandible, deflection of the mandible anteriorly. This is due to the premature contact. So we must treat the premature contact to prevent this problem. This premature contact or anterior deflection of the mandible, this lead to the anterior crossbite. So this is the functional anterior crossbite treated by removing any premature contact. Finally, skeletal anterior crossbite. Skeletal anterior crossbite when there is mal relationship skeletally between the upper and lower, between the maxilla and mandible. Meaning if there is any retrognathism of the maxilla or prognathism of the mandible or combination of both. This most commonly treated by functional appliance at early age to prevent the problem in the future, aggressive treatment in the future, or reduce the time of the treatment as possible. إلى هنا انتهى هذا الجزء. أتمنى استفدتم من هذا الموضوع. وأي أحد يحب يحمل هذا الموضوع موجود على موقع سلايد شير باسم دكتورة سارة خطيب. Interceptive Orthodontic سلايد شير باسم دكتورة سارة خطيب. شكرا لحسن استماعكم.